maybe I haven't seen her in the last couple of months, maybe she's already jumped this far. She started playing tricks on me, right? So I had to stay calm. I looked to my coach, told me again to be calm, to just execute the things that we've been working on. So I didn't even watch her take the first jump. And I knew that she had missed, and I'd watched the video afterwards, but she came down the runway, she planted the pole, and she went up, but she didn't even come close to the bar. So I heard the crowd go, oh. So then I had to take my jump, and I thought, okay, solidify your win here, Stacy. Get this one on the first attempt. I run down the runway. It's a bar I've never cleared before. I get my hands up. I accelerate my last two steps. I swing upside down. I really try to stay tight to the pole. And for some reason, I barely graze it. I barely feel it hit my leg, and it bounced off the upright. I thought, oh,
have it.
Just got to do another jump. But now it's back in her hands, and if she makes it, she's going to go in the first place, right? So it goes back to Tatiana. Everybody's going crazy for her. She's starting to run down the runway. I kind of look up to see what's going on. She's lowering the pole. She plants, and she swings, and I'm just like, okay, what's going to happen? And she doesn't make it again. And I thought, okay, I have another chance to make this bar. And so I get back on the runway. I look to my coach. He gives me a couple hand signals. I try to stay calm. I try to think I'm in Davisfield. I'm in Pocatello, Idaho. Training. I'm not in this crazy stadium. Everybody's going crazy. Just focus on the runway, Stacy. Just plant your pole, finish your jump. So I run down the runway, I plant the pole, I finish my jump, and I'm just trying my hardest to stay tight and straight on it, wrap the pole, and again, the same spot, I barely graze it off. I thought, oh my gosh. So we go back to Tatiana. She makes this, man, it's gonna be hard on my third attempt to come back, right? So the crowd's clapping again. She runs down the runway, and this time she just doesn't have the energy. She barely swings on her pole. She lands in the pit safely, but it's not even a good make. And I thought, okay, right here, Stacy, do it right here. I get back on the runway, encourage the crowd to clap for me down the runway, and I said, okay, just execute. Just be a little bit tighter. Just be a little bit more patient. Let this pole pick you up a little bit more, and you're going to make it. And I thought, and I did, and again, for some reason, this dang hip was just in the darn way, and I didn't make it. So a little bit anticlimactic. I had won at 15-1, a bar that I'd never cleared. I had to go to that next bar to make sure Tatiana wasn't going to make it. We battled it out for a minute, but it was a little bit anticlimactic because I won it on the jump before. And that will jump me right into my slides. Embrace the power of failing up. Failure is an opportunity to explore and challenge and improve my learning skills. As a pole vaulter, we always end on a failure. I just won the Olympic gold medal, right? And then I take three more jumps at a bar. I'm feeling really good about myself, and then I fail. What a bummer. I coach now. I do a lot of clinics. I run my own club in Boise, Idaho, and all my kids just want to work on the things that they're good at. They don't want to work on things they're not good at because they don't want to fail. They don't want to fail in front of me. They don't want to fail in front of their peers. But right now, we're just finishing our fall buildup, and I said, for me, if I hadn't done any of that gymnastics training, I probably wouldn't have made that bar at the Olympics. My coach said, Stacy, you're not awesome on the pole. We need to start working on gymnastics. I didn't grow up being a gymnast, but we started implementing a lot of gymnastics into my training, so I knew where I was in space and time and knew how to maneuver around the pole. And I tell my kids now, if we do a little bit of that, if we learn a couple skills off the runway, it's surely going to help your vault. It's surely going to help you know where you are in space and hopefully give you that extra little time to maneuver around the pole. So I tell my kids, don't be afraid to work on things that you're not good at. They just don't want to look funny in front of their friends. They don't want to doing handstands. They don't want to fall down. They want to do it right. But I said, the more times you do it, you're going to get better. You're going to get tighter. You're going to know where you are. You're going to be able to make more bars. The next thing, stay in the moment. I can't change what happened, right? I just failed at two jumps. I watched Kathy Freeman finish and go into history, and I'm kind of living in her moment. But I need to make this bar. So I could be thinking, oh gosh, woe is me, I just screwed up my first two attempts. Or I could say, you know what, this is a new opportunity for me to make this bar. Refocus, reset, think about what my coach asked me to do, and try to go and execute it. There's so many people that just get down on themselves because they failed at something and they're just ready to give up on it. And for me, I had three opportunities to make a bar, and every time I went to the back of the runway, I said, this is a new opportunity for me to make a new height. So I try to look at it like that. The next one, you can be competitive and supportive. This goes back to when Emma George was in the prelim. I wanted her to be in the final with me because I felt the best people always brought the best out of me. She was one of those people that I thought I was gonna go head to head with. And now I didn't have that opportunity to jump against her. And that was kind of a disappointing moment for me, and I surely know it was a disappointing moment for her. But for me, there was times in my career where I could have chosen the easier path. I could have went to a smaller meet. I could have won clearly, or I could choose to go to a bigger meet where all my top competitors were. And I've always chose to go to those bigger meets because even though I might have taken second or third, it really helped elevate me to become a better athlete, to be a little bit more alert, to learn from my mistakes and hopefully grow from them. If I went to the meets where I was gonna be the dominant person, I didn't feel like I was gonna grow as an athlete. I wasn't gonna be challenged enough as an athlete. So for me, to be around great people always helped me elevate me to greater things. And the last thing, my motto was to always dream big. For me, I would tell reporters, you never know what your thing is gonna be until you get out there and try something. And I love the thing for me now that I've retired and I've won my medal and got all these great accolades. I mean, I was on Wheaties box, that was pretty fun. I was on a Visa commercial that you guys watched. I was the first female athlete ever to grace a Super Bowl commercial in 2000. I've been photographed by some amazing photographers and put in some amazing magazines and done all these great things and traveled the world for free. But for me, now that I've retired, I love giving back to the sport that's given me so much. I've learned how to do things a little bit better. I've learned from my mistakes, and now I coach and train the youth of our communities, and doing camps and clinics all across the country, and now having my own facility in Boise, that spurs me on to teach these kids to not make the mistakes I did and to advance a little bit quicker and through the education that I've been able to give them. So also I've created a nonprofit called Stick Jumping, Try Something New. I've created bamboo sticks for young kids from elementary school all the way up to middle school of getting out there and trying a different sport. I think so many kids are used to playing basketball and football, and sometimes they're just kind of bored. They need to be challenged and try different things. And so the first thing when I was at a camp, I was brainstorming with some other of my colleagues, and I said, how do we get more pole vaulters out there? How do we inspire more people to try our sport? Because I think it's pretty amazing. We thought we need to go to the grassroots. We need to get to the kids, because the kids don't touch a pole vault pole until maybe their eighth grade year, if a high school coach is helping a junior high coach understand the event, but really not till their high school years. And because pole vault is such a technical event, it's either those really athletic kids that excel in it, and that's about it. So we thought, how do we get more kids involved? So we created stick jumping. And so we've gone into over 40 schools and touched probably and handed sticks off to more than 40,000 kids by doing different seminars and showing up at conventions and being in schools, that we've had over 40,000 kids fly on sticks. And the feedback that we've got from these educators and the teachers is really amazing, because the teachers are bored as well with some of the programs they're doing. They need something to stimulate them. I've heard from kids, it feels like Harry Potter being on a broomstick. I'm flying. I hear all these great comments from these kids, and it's just a bamboo stick. And we're not saying to swing upside down and be a pole vaulter. We just want kids to get out there and try something different. I've been in schools where there's a lot of money, and I've been in schools where there's no money. And one of the schools that really hit home for me was when I was back in Boston a couple years ago, in a school where it was a really rough school. These kids didn't want to hear my story. They didn't want to know how I achieved my gold medal. They wanted to know how much it would be worth if they went and sold it. And then I said, you know what, maybe we need to go outside and try stick jumping. And all of them were reluctant to go outside until one girl came up and said, you know what, I want to try it. And I'm glad she did, because she had legs up to here and she took off. We showed her a couple things, how to hold it, how to plant it in the ground, and she took off across the field. And then after that, a couple other kids started asking how to do it. They took off. And by the middle of the class, everybody was playing on sticks. By the end of the period, the bell rang, they were still out playing. The superintendent came out to watch us because they had no idea who we were. We came all the way from California, Boise, Idaho, to present the stick jumping curriculum to them. And the superintendent said, these kids, these 7th and 8th graders, are a hard crowd to crack. And my PE teacher has told me several times that I can't get these kids to even play basketball. And these kids are still playing, and the bell rang. And so finally we got them all back, and they said, are you guys coming back tomorrow? And I thought, oh my gosh, we just did something here. I don't know if they're all going to become pole vaulters, but they did something that was totally different. You know, some of these kids come from homes that I don't even know if they got fed that morning. You know, I don't even know if some of them had a bed to sleep in. But they went out and played for that minute, and they were a kid again. And that was something that really hit home for me. And it really turned into something that I want to keep pursuing, and I want to keep getting out to educators and see if this stick jumping program could be something more than what I thought it could be at first. And so, you know, when I come and talk to people, I want to know what your dream is. What are you going to go out and achieve? It doesn't have to be a gold medal. It could be something very simple. But if you don't set goals and aspire to go out there and try something, we're going to be complacent, right? Don't be afraid to go out and fail at something. I didn't think I was going to be very good at pole vaulting, but I went out and tried it. I kept working at it, and pretty soon, I have a gold medal to show for it, and I never thought that would be my dream. And so I'm really thankful to be here. I want you to know that great things can happen in any community. I was in Pocatello, Idaho. People said, you stayed in Pocatello for 15 years? And I did. I stayed there because it kept me centered, it kept me grounded, and I had a great support system from the community. And so I love coming and telling and sharing my story, and I just hope that you guys go out and dare to try something different. So thanks for having me.
Thank you.